Should the younger generation today accept a lower standard of living than their parents? I think that they shouldn't. I think that's pretty clear. I think it'd be crazy for them to do so, and it would kind of undermine the social contract that we have in this country if that was the case. Roz?
I think what we have to distinguish is the short term versus the medium and longer term. And if you are comparing people who are at the beginning of their working lives, who haven't yet had the opportunity to, if you like, rise through the ranks or progress through the workplace, haven't yet had time to do the kind of saving that their parents will have done, then actually it's unreasonable to expect them not to have a lower standard of living than generations which are coming towards the end of their working lives and have had opportunities to build up through their lifetime.
But when we talk about living standards, we're taking this into account, or we should take this into account already, so we can start to project that young adults won't have a good standard of living as their parents already. So yes, even though we should agree that we should appreciate for kind of life cycle effects, sure, no one should be rich and already retired when they're 22. That doesn't make much sense.
Exactly.
It's not going to work.
Exactly.
And we can see from comparing like with like, so 20-year-olds now with 20-year-olds, you know, 30 years ago, that actually it isn't panning out that way. It looks like they are going to have to accept a lower standard of living. Are you happy with that?
Again, I would dispute those figures. I think what we are doing is looking at 20-somethings, say, in the middle of a really bad recession, compared with a parental generation who, by the time they were in their 20s, had already worked for 6 or 7 years. The majority of younger people nowadays either left school at 18 or had some kind of further education. So they didn't start on the rung of the workplace ladder until much later in life than their parents.
This generation was supposed to, as in my generation, was supposed to be able to compete on the global stage. We weren't asked about this. We weren't consulted about it. We were told to do it. We said, you have no other choice. And so that's why we all had to go to university. That's what we were told. Now, you can't blame an 18-year-old for making these mistakes, right? But then the older generation didn't want to pay for it, collectively speaking. Not individually, right? Because it's really easy to wriggle out of it individually and say, well, I didn't take this decision, right? It was government. Well, sure, but people elect governments and there's a policy milieu, right? It seems that we have an underlying idea in this country, right, which is dominated. I mean, this idea has been taken up by this generation, the baby boomers, if you want, and adopted by them as kind of, you know, actually the future will kind of pan out, right? As long as I'm good, leave me alone. But they haven't recognized that all throughout their lives, the state, someone has stumped up for them, right?
The big issue here is debt. Right. And the encouragement societally for people to take on debt is one that worries me tremendously. And of course, the younger you are with debt when you start, before you've even bought a home, for example, the worse it will be for your life chances, in my view. Younger generations have to learn, in my view, that debt is itself not an answer to anything and doesn't create growth.
I think that argument is slightly spurious. I'll tell you why. Because debt itself is creating money as long as it really depends on what you're using it for. So if you're investing into something, that's great. If you're using that debt to pay off everyday goods, not so great. And that's
Absolutely. Kind
of what's happening. That's not good.
It's
right?
Not good.
But it's not their fault.
Correct. I'm not saying any of this is an individual's
But you're saying debt's bad
fault.
Per se. But we raised debts collectively before. We had huge debts, 250% of GDP, and we built homes with it. Right? We don't do that today because we don't think government should even be doing that. We don't even think that we should
be taxing. I think government should be doing that.
Great. Then I think that's probably where we might agree on. Certainly.
No, I think what the big distortion in our economy, which is driving a lot of the problems that younger generations have got, actually, is that house prices are too high.
Debt seems to be, obviously, your big issue, where I'm not so sure about that. But clearly, we want the next generation to have a better standard of living than their parents.
But they will have to work for it, and it will take time. You can't expect them to have it immediately in the middle of the kind of global crisis and economic weakness that we are facing right now.
And I'm not sure they do either, but let's see what happens. Thank you.
Thank you.